then 4, 8 is not there, 16 is not there, 32 is not there, then 64, 128, 256 is not there, 512 is there, and 1024 is there. So if I add these, hopefully the result will come to be 1734. Okay. Fine. So in the last class,
so explain the past one, please, once.
Okay, sure. Oh, in fact, sorry, I forgot to ask you that whether everybody has understood the solutions or not. Sorry, that's my mistake. Forget about this one. Here in this problem, you are asked to convert from hex to base 4. In hexadecimal, what is the base or radix?
16.
In base 4, what is the radix?
4.
4. So are they related in power relationship?
4 square equals to 16.
Are they related by the power relationship?
4 square equals to 16. That means yeah. 2 at time.
So 16 is equal to 4 square. That means any base 16 symbol can be uniquely represented by a two-digit combination of base 4 symbols. Isn't it?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
In base 4 system, what are the possible symbols?
0, 1, 2, 3. 0, 1, 2, and 3.
These are the only four symbols possible. Okay. Now let I have one hex symbol to be star. I want to convert it into base 4. Let the two symbols of base 4 be A and B. So star in hex can be represented by AB in base 4. Okay, now this star can be anything between 0 to F, 0 to 9, and A to F. And this AB individually, they may be anything between 0 to 3. Okay, so if I go for the decimal equivalent of AB in base 4, what will be that value? Now 4a plus b. Clear or not?
Yes, sir, clear.
Fine. Now let me erase this part. Fine. Now I have the symbol A. So that should be represented by a combination of A and B in such a manner that A is equal to 4A plus B. Now A means how much? Nothing but 10 in decimal. So what should be the combinations for AB?
8 equals.
Remember A, B individually cannot be. Yeah. Ha, bolo bolo. Koto bolo?
A equals to 2, B equals
A is equal to
2, 0.
So both are 2.
Both are 2, yeah. Fine. So that is 4 into 2 plus 2. So that means AB both are 2. So A is equivalent to 2, 2 in base 4. Now 2. Yes, sir. What should be A and what should be B?
0,
0, 2.
0, 2.
Yeah. 0. So in this way, you can evaluate the others. For example, for D, the value of D is how much? 13, isn't it? So that's equal to, 4A plus B. So
3, what 1,
the
3, 1,
3, 3, 1. 3, 1.
So this way you can find out the AB combination for all the hex digits.
Hello sir.
Kichu bolle baba.
Could you explain the 0-2 once again, sir? I have not got it.
0-2, fine. What I have is 4a plus b is equal to 2. Now, in what can be the possible values of a? What can be the possible values of a?
0, 1, 2, 3.
0, 1, 2, 3. What can be the possible values of b?
0, 1, 2, 3.
In case a is above 0, can the result become 2? Can the summation result become 2?
No.
So a has got to be 0. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
So, and in case a is 0, what is the only possible value of b?
2.
2, sir. 2.
So that is 0 is equivalent to 0 in hex is equivalent to 0, 2 in base 4. Got it?
Yes, sir.
Fine. Can I proceed? Or yes, any sir. Other problem of anybody? Fine. In the last class, we dealt with the conversion of one digital number to some other reduction number and from some reduction to one decimal number. Now, and we have also told you that in digital electronics or in computer related field, we mostly deal with the binary number system. But what about the common people? In the common world, we do not deal with the 1-0 patterns or the binary patterns. What do? We normally deal with which number
decimal system? Decimal.
Decimal system. So, but all the computational facilities, they must be dealing with the binary number system. So there must be some interface between the external world, the common world, and the digital world. Because the common world is dealing with the decimal number system, whereas the digital world is dealing with the binary number system. So there must be somebody as one interface between these two. So here you are as if operating as that interface, and you have to convert the decimal number to binary before feeding it to the computer system. And after getting the result from the computer system, you have to convert that binary pattern into the decimal pattern again, so that the common people can understand what the result is. But the problem is you may not be always available. There is one computation facility. There is one common layman, but the common layman may not be that conversant with the conversion process between these two number systems, decimal to binary conversion and the binary to decimal conversion. The common layman may not be aware of that. So what that common layman or what people can do there is, instead of going for the binary conversion, they normally take help of binary codes. What do you mean by binary codes? Normally, decimal number system is dealing with how many symbols?
So two.
One decimal number, 10 symbols, 0 to 9. 0 to 9, these 10 symbols are there in the decimal number system. Now, if we can prepare certain unique codes for each of the symbols, say I have prepared one particular code for 0, then one particular code for 1, 8, 9. For each of the decimal symbols, we have constructed one unique binary code. Now say I have to enter the number 349. So what I'll do is, from this table, or this from this encoding rule, what I'll do is this is basically one lookup table type of thing. For three, let me find out from this lookup table what is the pattern. In place of three, I'll insert that. For four, I have to find out what is the corresponding pattern. I have to enter that. For nine, what is the corresponding pattern? I'll enter that. So this will be the binary code for 349 in decimal. Now, after computation, the computer system will once again produce one set of binary patterns. So from there, once again, we'll refer back to this lookup table and we'll go for the reverse decoding. That's given the binary pattern, what is the corresponding symbol? Given this binary pattern, what is the corresponding symbol? Given this binary pattern, what is the corresponding symbol? Given this pattern, what is the corresponding binary symbol? Decimal symbol. Okay. So that if I have to go for the binary codes, we must know what is that corresponding unique lookup table or the encoding rule. This table is basically following certain encoding rule, and that for each encoding rule will be having one unique pattern or unique lookup table. And remember, while decoding, we have to refer to the same lookup table. Otherwise, we'll be facing trouble. Now, let us see how many decimal symbols are there?
10.
Now, to encode 10 decimal symbols, minimum how many binary bits would be required? To encode uniquely by a binary pattern, minimum how many binary bits would be required? দশটা সিম্বলকে ইউনিকলি বাইনারি কোড দিয়ে রিপ্রেজেন্ট করতে গেলে হাউ মেনি মিনিমাম বাইনারি বিটস উড বি রিকোয়ার্ড
4
শুনতে পেলাম না বাবা আরেকবার বলো
4
হোয়াই 4 হোয়াই নট 3
স্যার ইন 3 ইন কেস অফ 3 দ্য টোটাল উইল বি 7
নো 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 ইউ আর রং ইউ আর বিট রং
Isn't it?
Isn't it? So as I have 10 distinct symbols, those 8 binary distinct patterns will not be sufficient. So I have to increase it by 1. So the minimum number of bits that should be used for uniquely encoding the 10 decimal symbols is n is equal to 4. So using 4 bits, how many distinct combinations are available?
So 16.
But they are definitely ranging from 0000 to
1111.
Okay, these are the 16 distinct combinations. Out of the 16 distinct combinations, how many are required actually?
10, sir.
So
only 10 are required.
How many possible encoding rules are there? Now that is 16, C, 10. These many possible unique binary encoding rule is there. Because I may go for 0 here, I may go for 9 here, I may go for 1 here, I may go for 2 here. But you may prefer to go for 9 here, somebody may go for 2 here, 0 here, 5 here. Okay.
So 16C10 is the possible number of unique binary coding rules.
Coding rules. So how many? It may be several thousand.
Yes, yes.
Several thousand. So now out of the several thousand, you might be using one. I might be using one. Your three seers might be using something else. So there'll be a lot of confusion. So what people have done is they have made some out of those several thousand standard. So there are certain standard binary encoding rules. 1 minute, anchor. So basically, these in all these encoding rules are termed as binary coded decimals, or in short, BCDs. The most common BCD rule is termed as the standard BCD or normal BCD or 8421 BCD. Now, in one binary coded decimal, in that binary pattern, how many binary bits would be there?
Four, sir.
Four.
So let they be A, B, C, D. So each A, B, C, D are nothing but one binary bit, either 0 or 1. Okay? Now, in the standard BCD or normal BCD or 8421 BCD, what the people does is they assign weight 8 here, weight 4 here, weight 2 here, and weight 1 here. So in case these are the weight assignments, so what will be the corresponding ABCD value? The same equivalent value of this ABCD.
8A plus
4B
plus 2C plus D.
Yeah. A plus 4B plus 2C plus D. Okay.
So this is like the standard way of conversion only, no?
Yeah. That's why this is called the standard BCD or the normal BCD.
So why do we need other forms of coding, sir? This is enough, right?
But it is not always enough.
Okay.
We'll see that. There are certain specific advantages of the some other type of BCD rules.
Okay, sir.
For 0, what will be the 8421 code? What will be the ABCD values?
0, 0, 0, 0.
All 0. For 1, 0, 0, 0, 1. For 2, What about for these six?
So this is not necessary.
Yeah. Normally, if you use four binary bits, there are 16 possible combinations, out of which we are using these first 10, 00002 1001 1010 2 1111. These six binary combinations are not utilized in 8421 or normal or standard BCD. So these are called invalid normal BCD codes. So now say I have this particular binary pattern from some source. I have to decode this. What will be the corresponding decoded value? Now, before decoding, let me go for the encoding. Say I have 1684. I want to encode it into normal BCD. So what will be the answer? What will be the encoded version of this 684 in normal
0, BCD? 0110
0100 0100 0100 0100 0100 0100 0100 0100 0100 0100 0100 0100 0100 0100 0100 0100 0100 0100 0100 0100 0100 0100 0100 0100 0100 0100 0100 0100 0100 0100 0100 0100 0100 0100 0100 0100 0100 0100 0100 0100 0100 0100 0100 0100 0100 0100 0100 0100 0100 0100 0100 0100 0100 0100 0100 0100 0100 0100 0100 0100 0100 0100 0100 0100 0100 0100 0100 0100 0100 0100 0100 0100 0100 0100 0100 0100 0100 0100 0100 0100 0100 0100 0100 0100 0100 0100 0100 0100 0100 0100 0100 0100 0100 0100 0100 0100 0100 0100 0100 0100 0100 0100 0100 0100 0100 0100 0100 0100 0100 0100 0100 0100 0100 0100 0100 0100 0100 0100 0100 0100 0100 0100 0100 0100 0100 0100 0 BCD. Now say we are told that some binary pattern is available in standard BCD. I have to decode it, and that particular pattern from that source available is this. What will be the corresponding decoding?
So what the decoder
will do is he will find that this is 5, this is 2, but this is error. So there is no valid BCD code like 1010. This comes under the invalid normal BCD codes. So it will raise one error flag to indicate that there is something wrong in this code. Okay? You understand how normally things are done? In case some invalid normal BCD code is available, it will simply raise one error flag because nobody knows what was the actual value. But due to some mistake somewhere, this erroneous code has been generated. Okay. So that's what we call about 8421 or the normal or the standard BCD. The next BCD rule is termed as the excess-free BCD rule. Here, say I want to generate the excess-free BCD code of one decimal digit DI. This DI can be anything between 0 to 9. My task is to find out the excess-free BCD code for the decimal digit DI. DI is a decimal digit, so its value can range from 0 to 9. Okay. Now, how to find the excess-free BCD code for DI? Now, you first add 3. With DI. That means generate DI plus 3. Now find out.
Sir,
the.
Sir, DI is the decimal bit, sir.
Decimal digit. Decimal digit.
Okay.
One decimal symbol, you can say.
Yes, 0 to 9.
0 to 9.
Yes, sir.
So to find out the excessive BCD code for the decimal digit DI, we have to add 3 with it. That means we have to generate DI plus 3. Now, whatever is its value, convert it into a 4-bit binary. Whatever is the value of DI plus 3, convert it into a 4-bit binary. Got the rule? Is the rule clear?
Yes, sir.
Because each digit is added, is given a bias of 3. So that's why it is called the excess 3. So each digit, not only a single digit. Whatever digits are there in a particular number, all digits must be added by 3. Now each of those DI plus 3 should be converted into, I am talking about binary conversion. All DI plus 3 has to be converted into 1 4-bit binary. For example,
sir,
it is
0. Sir, I have a doubt, sir. What if DI is equals to 9? So then DI plus 3 will be 12. And we have no coding, means decoding rule for 12.
Can you not convert? Let me finish. Can you not convert 12 into 4-bit binary?
No, sir. That's the main problem.
Yes, sir, we can.
So that's it. So there is no problem.
Means that will be the invalid one, sir. But sir, that will be the invalid one. No?
Why invalid? Invalid one with respect to what?
With respect to standard BCD.
Standard? Are you going for the standard BCD?
No. Okay, I got it, sir.
We are going for some other BCD conversion rule.
Yes, sir. Got it.
In the standard BCD, what we did is each DI was converted into a 4-bit binary.
Yes, sir.
For example, no, accessory BCD, each DI plus 3 should be converted into a 4-bit binary.
Yes, sir.
That's the difference only.
Got it, sir. Yes, sir.
So we have available till 16, right, sir? Sir, then why can't we take 5 or 4 instead of 3?
Because this addition of 3 has got some arithmetic advantage. While dealing with the addition processes, subtraction processes, we'll see those things.
Okay, sir.
Plus some other specific advantage is also there for this excess BCD. We'll explain those things at a later point of some other class, not in today's class, because you won't be able to understand that. After going for some 2-3 more classes, you will be able to understand that one. Fine. For 0, what should be the excess BCD?
Yes, sir.
You have to add 3 with the 0. So the result becomes 3.
Yes, sir.
Convert 3 into 4-bit binary. So that becomes 0011. So for 1, that should be 1. Now, what are the invalid excess BCD codes?
Sir, 0000 to 0010.
0000
to, yeah, at all. These 3 and after 12 to 16, that part means 15.
These 6 are invalid excess BCD codes. এটাকে এবারে অনেকে x apostrophe s cbcd code বলে। Okay. So what you find is those 0000 to 0010, these three are perfectly valid normal BCD code. They become invalid excessive BCD code. Similarly, now 1010 to 1100, these three are invalid standard BCD codes, but they become valid excessive BCD code. Okay. So whether a pattern belongs to valid code or not, that depends upon the type of encoding rule that has been followed. Another rule we'll study today, that is called 4221 BCD. So that means instead of 842, instead of 8421 BCD, now we have 4221 BCD, and that means the weights for ABCD are no longer 8421. Now the weights are 4221. You understand that? So if the four bits are ABCD, that means the decimal equivalent value of this ABCD will be 4A plus 2B plus 2C plus D. Okay. Achha, by the way, in some competitive examinations or in some job examination, you may find that some words are coming with a bar. So somebody tells that you have to find out the 4221 BCD code for a particular decimal number. Now, what is the significance of this bar? Bar signifies that the corresponding weight is a negative weight. In case you find that one particular weight is coming with a bar, don't get confused. That is basically nothing but one negative weight. That means the weights are 4, then 2, then minus 2, and then 1. So had it been the same thing, this will become 4a plus 2b minus 2c plus d. Okay. So please do not get confused or do not get afraid of what is this bar? I have never seen it. Don't go for that type of confusion. So simply assume that whenever one weight comes in the form of a bar, there is nothing but a negative weight. But we bar type of weights, a negative weights. We normally go for all the positive weights. But still, it's examination. They may try to judge whether you know that negative weight concept or not. That's it, nothing else. But here we are not going for that negative weight, we will go for only the positive weights. Now for zero, what will be the pattern?
In this
for zero, what will be the pattern?
0000.
Hey, yeah. In
hello, sir.
In 4221, what? Sir, Shruti Bachchan, your voice is muffled.
Excuse me, sir. Can you hear me now?
Yeah.
Sir, in this system, how do we differentiate between B and C? Sir, both of them have weight 2.
No, let it be there. Instead of going for your confusion, let me ask you to solve my requirement first. Yes, you tell me what will be the pattern for 0 in 4221.
Sir, four zeros.
Yeah. Four zeros. For 1?
301.
For 2?
0010.
Or
or
0, 1, 0, 0.
There are two possible possibilities for two.
Yeah.
Yes, sir.
For three.
Sir, 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1,
1 0 0 1 or 0 1 1 0 5 1 0 0 1 or 0 1 1 0 5 1 1 0 0 1 or 0 1 1 0 7 1 1 0 1 or 1 0 1 0 8 1 1 1 0 and 9 1 1 1 1 Okay. Any confusion?
No, sir.
So that means what you find is in a 4-2-1 BCD for 0, 1, 8, and 9, there are unique representations. But for the other symbols, that means 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, this 6, but there are two possible possibilities. For 2, I have two possible codes 0010 or 0100. Similarly, for 7, 1101 or 1011. So which one to do? Which one to go for? So that will come at a later stage. When we'll discuss the utility of XSTBCD, at that point of time, we'll go for this the choice of this 4-2-1 BCD. How to go for the proper choice of 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. Okay, let this confusion be with you for the time being. Okay?
So here nothing is invalid.
Shunte pachhi na baba?
In this method, nothing is invalid.
Probably. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. Yeah, nothing is invalid. But once I go for the choice of 0010, in that case, 0100 becomes invalid. Isn't it? Once I decide that, okay, for 2, I will not go for this, I will go for this. In that case, 0100 becomes invalid. Similarly, if I decide that for 6, I will go for this, not 1100. In that case, this becomes invalid. So ultimately, 6 patterns will be invalid always. Because you cannot, as you are going for unique conversion, you cannot take more than 10 codes. You cannot take help of more than 10 patterns. But using 4 bits, you are generating 16 patterns. So 6 will definitely be going to be invalid patterns. So here also we'll find that there will be 6 invalid patterns. But for the time being, as we are keeping the options open, so nothing is for the time being invalid code. For the time being, remember, I am talking about the for the time being. But once we decide which code will be going for 2 or 3 or 4 or 5, 6 or 7, then 6 patterns will become invalid. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Fine. Next, another code is there, which will be extensively used in especially instrumentation field, that is or simply as the name suggests, while generating the binary, this type of gray code, some reflection, concept of reflection or taking mirror images are utilized. So for example, the code starts from the codes of 0 and 1. For the 0, the code is 0. for 1, the code is 1. These are the decimal numbers. This left hand side, I have the decimal numbers. Right hand side, I am having the codes definitely in binary, which is the nothing but the gray code. Now, in decimal numbers, only zero, there cannot be only 0 and 1. There may be larger numbers also. So the next higher numbers are 2 and 3. To find out the codes of 2 and 3, what we do is we place one mirror here. Take the mirror image. What we'll find is here 1 will come, then a 0 will come. If you take the mirror image of this, you'll be getting 1, 0. Isn't it?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Now, what is the next thing? You place leading zeros above the mirror and leading ones below the mirror. So these are the four gray codes for 0, 1, 2, 3. For 0, the code is 0, 0. For 1, it is 0, 1. For 2, it is 1, 1. For 3, it is 1, 0. Once again, in the decimal world, this only 0, 1, 2, 3 are not sufficient. I have larger numbers also. So next is 4, 5, 6, 7. Please take out the mirror from here. Place the mirror here. Take the mirror image. Then once again, do the same thing. Above the mirror, place leading zeros. Below the mirror, place leading ones. So these are the 8 gray codes for the numbers 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Then 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. Take out the mirror from this place. Place the mirror here. Take the mirror image. 100, 101, then 111. 110, 010, 011, 001, and 000. So what is the next task to be done?
Adding zeros
and leading ones.
You have to add leading zeros above the mirror. And leading ones below the mirror. Okay. So 0 to 15 is also not sufficient. I may have to go for larger numbers. Then comes 16, 17 to 31. Then comes 32 to 63. So this way, you have to go on taking reflections and adding leading zeros and leading ones as the process has been described to generate the larger numbers. Now say my requirement becomes, we have to generate one gray code for the decimal number. 1 minute. This large decimal number, I want to find out its gray code. Huh? Kyo kichu bolchile?
Sir, why do we need numbers above 9? Sir, we just need single digit numbers, right?
Remember, this is not BCD. This is not BCD.
Okay, sir. Okay.
It's not binary coded decimal. Here, the gray code is corresponding to a decimal number.
Okay, sir. Got it, sir.
Here, we are not going for the BCD conversion rule. It's a totally different concept here. Okay. So now we have a requirement to generate a gray code for this large number. Now, if you proceed in this reflection method, what you will find that to find out the gray code for this large number, you may require a page or sheets of pages which may be several kilometers of length. That's really unmanageable. That is not, that should not be the process that should be followed for finding out the gray pattern for a large decimal number. But remember, this is the way that gray code was initiated. That's why in the name itself, it is there, the gray reflected binary codes. But definitely, as our requirement grew, we definitely cannot follow this reflection method to generate a gray code for a large decimal number. Okay. Achha, by the I'm going for the next page. Some of you must tell me what are these numbers. Achha, by the way, one thing I have forgot to tell you, that normal BCD, standard BCD or 8-4-1 BCD, that conversion rule is so common that if we say you have been given one BCD of a number, by BCD, if you do not mention what type of BCD, by default that comes under the normal BCD or standard BCD or 8-4-1 BCD category. But if you have to mention some other BCD rule, we have to specifically mention that type. That means you have to specifically mention 8-4-1 BCD, sorry, XS3 BCD or 4-2-1 BCD or something else. But if you say simply a BCD, that means we are referring to the normal BCD or standard BCD or the 8-4-1 BCD. Because that is so common in this world. Okay, so here as I have not mentioned anything with this BCD, so I am referring to the 8-4-1 BCD. Okay. Achha, better not to go for the BCD. I'm going for the binary. আরিয়ান ক্লাসটা কটায় ছিল
স্যার? একটু নেটওয়ার্ক প্রবলেম হচ্ছে। নেটওয়ার্ক প্রবলেম হচ্ছিল স্যার একটু।
ও আচ্ছা। আই হ্যাভ লিস্টেড দ্য নাম্বারস 0 to 15, সো হোয়াট উইল বি দ্য করেসপন্ডিং বাইনারি? 4-bit, আই এম গোয়িং ফর দ্য 4-bit বাইনারি। Now tell me somebody, what was that 4-bit gray code for 0? probably that was 0000. For 1, that was 0001. For 2, probably it was 0011. Okay. Then it comes. Okay, I'll go.
0110.
0110.
0110. একটু চেক করে নিতে ঠিক করেছি কিনা, মনে হচ্ছে ঠিকই করেছি। থ্যাংক ইউ। Now, given any large decimal number, say 3, 6, 4, 2, 8, 9, you can definitely convert it into binary using either subtraction method or by long division method, isn't it?
Yes, given sir.
Any large decimal number, we can definitely, maybe it's it may become a lengthy process, but still we can convert it into binary. I'm not talking about the BCD. I'm going for the conversion, binary conversion. Okay, so that by, that is by subtraction of the powers of twos, or by subtraction or by the long division process by two. So definitely that can be converted into a binary pattern. Now, given a binary pattern, if there is one well-defined rule to convert the binary pattern into its gray pattern, I can definitely find out the gray pattern for any decimal number, be it whatever its length, because whatever may be the length, I can convert the decimal to binary. And as there is one unique binary to gray conversion rule, I can apply that rule to convert that binary pattern into the gray pattern.
Yes, sir.
You got my logic?
Yes, sir.
Fine. So now the task becomes that
sir,
I have to
sir, find... sir.
Haha, follow.
Sir, I had not got the point, sir. Could you please repeat once more?
Sure. Now, if I know there is a unique conversion rule from binary pattern to the gray pattern, if that exists, I do not know whether that actually exists or not. If that is available, I can convert this into binary. I'm not talking about I'm converting into BCD. I'm converting into yes, binary. Then I'm then applying
binary to gray.
Binary to gray conversion rule to find out the gray.
Yes, sir.
And definitely I can go the reverse way also.
Yes, sir.
Given one gray pattern, first I'll find out its binary equivalent binary pattern. I do not know whether that is available or not. That conversion rule, whether that is available or not, yet I know do not know. But if it is available, I can convert the gray to binary, and then from binary to decimal is also one easy process. Okay. So now our task is to find out whether there is any binary to gray conversion rule, and that to unique conversion rule or not. See, here in this table, I have listed the binary patterns and the corresponding gray patterns for the numbers 0 to 15. Now, from here, by observation, what we find is the most significant bits of binary as well as gray are always identical. Just look at this table. The most significant bits of binary as well as gray are always same. Are they differing or they are always same?
What does significant bits mean?
The first one, zero or one.
Most significant bit. Most significant, by the way, okay, let me say ABCD is the pattern, 4-bit pattern. So in normally, a normal binary, if this one binary pattern, what will be the weight here?
What will be the weight here? One.
So which one is having most significance?
A.
Okay, so this is the most significant bit position, and this is the LSB position, least significant bit position. Okay, acha, by the way, that term bit is basically coming from binary digit B and IT. So this bit is coming from this binary digit. Of binary digit, this B is coming, and from digit, the last I and P are coming.
Sir.
Okay.
Sir, can we call the digit of the decimal system as the decimal bit and something like that?
No.
So bit only defined for the binary system, no?
Yeah, bit only is for binary digit. Bit is the abbreviation of binary digit.
Okay, sir.
This 0 and 1, they are also digits. But when that is referred to binary system, then it is that becomes a bit.
Yes, sir.
Because that is now referred as binary digit.
So is this bit and the unit bit the same or different?
Because in that storage also stores either logic 0 or logic 1. So that is nothing but a bit. Okay. They are not different. They are same. But that comes in the context of storage. Here it comes in the context of the number system. That's the only difference. When you are using one storage, there in the storage, you are storing a particular number. So one particular storage can store one particular bit.
Okay.
Or whether one particular storage can store the number of bits. So that's storing of one byte. Okay. So by the way, bit e jokhon aslam tokhon baki chilo jene nao jano tumra byte is nothing but
8 bits, sir.
Eight
consecutive bits taken at a time is called a byte. There is another term, nibble. What is nibble? 4 consecutive bits taken at a time is called a nibble. Chatte bit ke ekshonge ekta unit hisebe jodi consider koro, that is termed as a nibble.
So that means two nibble is
considered a byte.
Okay,
fine.
So when a binary codes ki shop golo tole nibble hobe. So when a binary codes je ache, they also constitute of 4 bits na, to ogulo shob ki nibble bolte pare
amra. Definitely. They are all nothing but unit nibbles.
Okay sir.
At a BCD code, they are nothing but nibbles. Each are nibbles. আচ্ছা এক মিনিট আমি একটু আসছি। হ্যাঁ সরি, একটু বাইরে যেতে হয়েছিল। হ্যাঁ হিয়ার জাস্ট বাই লুকিং অ্যাট দিস টেবল হোয়াট উই ক্যান ফাইন্ড ইজ দ্য মোস্ট সিগনিফিকেন্ট বিটস অফ বাইনারি অ্যান্ড দ্য গ্রে আর ডিফারেন্ট অর সেম?
সেম সেম স্যার, সেম
সেম। সো দ্য ফার্স্ট স্টেপ অফ আই এম বেসিক্যালি আই এম গোয়িং ফর দ্য বাইনারি to gray conversion rule. The first step that has to be followed is copy MSB. That means given the binary pattern, blindly copy the MSB. Now definitely we cannot copy blindly because you have to keep your eyes open to find out what the MSB is. So you have to simply copy the MSB of the binary pattern. Okay? So given my binary pattern is 1001, that is for the number, decimal number 9. So what I have is the corresponding gray MSB is available. The most significant bit of the gray is available. Now, how do you find the other three gray bits? Any idea? Just use your common sense or intuition. Just simply observe the table and try to give your answer.
Sir, 8 er kom hole same ar 8 er beshi hole opposite.
No, but once you here say you have been supplied with the binary number, how will you proceed then? I am not going for the conversion. I am not keeping my binary to gray conversion rule confined to this only 16 decimal numbers. That should be one general conversion process. So whether the given binary number, the decimal equivalent for the binary number is less than a particular number or not, I do not know. I should not be concerned about that also. Only what we should be concerned about is the given binary pattern. Any idea?
So the next bit is the complement of the left bit to the most significant bit, right to the right.
Next bit is the complement of the
bit to the right of the most significant bit.
Say MSB.
This table is only for helping you. তোমাকে যখনই বললাম যে এই নাম্বারটা করো, তুমি কি করে করবে? এখানে 8 থেকে 11 সেরকম কোনো গল্প আছে এখানে?
স্যার
sir, whenever we
First of all, the first step is definitely going to the copy the MSB. The second step is, if the last input bit, remember what is the input? This is the input. This is the binary pattern is your input. You are going for binary to gray conversion. So what is the input and what is the output?
Binary is the input and gray
binary
conversion
is output. Gray is the output. Yes. Fine. So, copy the MSB. Copy the MSB means copy the MSB of the input. Now, for the next bit onwards, what you have to do is, if the last input bit, is zero, if the last input bit is zero, copy the present input bit, otherwise complement it. Copy the MSB. Now next bit onwards. Next bit onwards means, now what is the your input? This is your input. This zero is the input, present input. What is the last what was the last input?
One.
So last input is zero or one? Yeah. As per the rule, what you have to do?
So last one. Input bit so is LSB,
no? No. Last input bit means if this is your present time, if it is your time scale, if this is your present time instant, this is your last time instant, this is your next time instant.
Sir, we are going from left to right.
This last present is not in the terms of significance, it is in terms of the time of occurrence. Okay. So, when you are going for the binary to gray conversion, what is your last input? There is no last input. The present input is the most significant bit of the binary pattern. So I have to blindly, I have to simply copy it so that one was copied at the output. Now I am going for the next input. So what is the present input now?
Zero.
So what is the last input?
One.
So if the last input is one, what you have to do with the present input?
Complement it.
So what is the present input? Zero. So if you complement it, what will you get?
One.
Fine. So duto bit hoye gelo. So this is now going to be your present input. What is that?
Zero.
So what is the last input now?
Zero.
So if the last input is zero, what you have to do with the present input?
Complement.
Copy that.
Copy.
So,
sir, but the last input is one.
So last input will be from binary,
no? Now, what is the present input? I have dealt with the three in binary inputs.
What is the present input?
One. So what is the last input?
Zero.
0. If the last input is 0, what do you do with the present input?
Copy.
Copy. So this should be the gray pattern for 9. As per the, if my binary to gray conversion rule is correct, this should be the gray pattern for 9. So see from the table whether that is the gray pattern for 9 or not.
Yes, sir.
Let me go for something else. Let me go for the pattern for 5. For 5, what is the binary pattern?
0101.
Fine. Now apply the rule.
0.
So that is copied. Zero. Then what is the present input?
1.
Last input
one.
Zero. What is the last input?
Zero.
Zero.
As the last input is 0, what you have to do with the present input?
Copy.
So that one gets copied. So this, what is the present input?
Zero.
What is the last input?
One.
So what we have to do with the present input?
Complement.
So zero is
one.
One as one. Now what is the present input?
One.
Last input?
Zero.
So what to do with the present input?
Copy.
So this 0111 should be the gray code for 5. See, that is there.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So you try some other pattern yourself, go for 11. That is 1011. Tell me what should be the gray pattern for this one. For this one, MSB?
1.
Then next bit?
Last input is 1, so complement.
1110.
Then
last input 0, so copy.
Then
last input 1, complement 0.
That's
yes,
it.
Sir.
Okay, so 11 is that. Fine. I think the process is clear to everybody. If anybody is still having any doubt, I'll go for another example. Dorkar hole bolo. Hope there is no doubt. Fine.
Sir,
find out the gray pattern. Haha, kyo kichu bolle.
Sir, bolchi sir, ami ekta notun device the connect korchi sir, ekta admit kore den. Laptop e ekta issue. Issue also, sir.
Sure.
Okay.
Take us. A pattern, say this is one gray binary pattern. You have to find out its corresponding gray.
So, konta, sir?
Bolo, MSB.
One.
A pattern.
Sir, one.
One, then
paper one, detective one, paper zero,
very good. This is the gray code and the other one is the binary code. Okay, so now we have one concrete binary to gray conversion rule. So given whatever large decimal number, I should not be afraid of converting that into grade, because I know how to convert that decimal number into binary. And once I get the binary pattern, I can easily find out the corresponding gray pattern by applying this two-step rule. Now we have to go for the reverse process. This is given the gray pattern, we have to find out the corresponding binary pattern. That means I'm a table from the right hand side and left hand side here. So what should be the process? Is it not? The first step must be the same. Because from this table we find that the most significant bit of the gray pattern is nothing replicated as the most significant bit of the binary pattern. Take will be nothing but copy the MSB. First step, take no doubt. That's it. Fine.
So now what about the second
step? What should be now the second step?
So 0 to flip or 1A right take to the
edge. 0 to? জিরোতে
জিরো এনকাউন্টার করলে ফ্লিপ হয়ে যাবে বিটটা আর ওয়ান এনকাউন্টার করলে সেভ করতে
ভেরি গুড সো দ্যাট মিনস ইউ মিন টু দা ইফ লাস্ট ইনপুট বিট ইজ ওয়ান কপি দ্য প্রেজেন্ট ইনপুট বিট আদারওয়াইজ কমপ্লিমেন্ট ইট ইজ ইট টকিং অ্যাবাউট দিস আর ইজ সাজেস্টিং দিস
ইয়েস
Let us see. Once again, let me go for the line. The grid code for 9 is 1101. Okay, let me find out whether I arrive at here or not. So copy the MSB. MSB is copied. Present input is how much?
One.
Last digit one.
Last input is how much?
So copy. Last digit one, so copy.
One. Have to copy it. So definitely it is not coming.
So right theke aste hobe.
রাইট থেকে তো আমি আসতে পারবো না, সেটা আমি আই ক্যানট কপি দে লিসিং বিট,
ওকে,
তাই না? আই হ্যাভ টু স্টার্ট ফ্রম দ্য এমএসবি ওনলি, সো এটা হলো না কোনো ভুল হোক সাজেস্ট করো আর কোন এনি আদার সাজেশন হাত তুলে দিলে আমাকে বলো আর টেকিং টাইম আর জাস্ট ওয়েটিং ফর মি ঠিক আছে দেখো আর একটু সময় দিই দেখে নাও। যা আচ্ছা, আমার নেটওয়ার্কের একটু প্রবলেম হয়েছে, আমি আবার জয়েন করছি। আমার স্ক্রিনটা আমি দেখতে পাচ্ছ না, ইন দ্য মিডিয়ায় তোমরা ভাবতে থাকো, আমার 2 মিনিট সময় লাগবে। হ্যাঁ, কিছু আইডিয়া বেরোলো?
স্যার
বল।
স্যার মোস্ট সিগনিফিকেন্ট বিট তা সেটাই কপি করে দেব, তারপর
হ্যাঁ
যদি ওয়ান থাকে
সেটা তো
লাস্ট
হয়েছে।
ইনপুট তাহলে হ্যাঁ, আর সেকেন্ড প্রসেসটা শুধু রিভার্স হবে, মানে লাস্ট বিট যদি ওয়ান হয় তাহলে সেম কপি করে দেব, আর যদি লাস্ট বিট জিরো হয়
সেটাই
তাহলে
করতে হবে।
কমপ্লিমেন্ট।
তোমাদের কে একজন বললো, আমি সেটা করে দেখলাম যে হলো না। আচ্ছা, এবার আমি সাজেস্ট করে দিচ্ছি।
আর স্যার রাইট থেকে তো আসা যাবে না।
না, জাস্ট এই চেঞ্জটা করছি। ওয়েল, বাইনারি টু গ্রে কনভার্সন, একটা ইনপুটকে তুমি কপি করছো বা কমপ্লিমেন্ট করছো, হাউ আর ইউ ডিসাইডিং দ্যাট? হু ইজ ডিসাইডিং হোয়েদার দ্য প্রেজেন্ট ইনপুট শুড বি কপিড অর কমপ্লিমেন্টেড হোয়েন ইউ আর গোয়িং ফর দ্য বাইনারি টু গ্রে কনভার্সন?
The
ইউ
last
লিভ
bit.
অ্যাসাইড দ্য ইনপুট, ইয়া, লাস্ট ইন লাস্ট ইনপুট, লাস্ট ইনপুট বিট ইজ কন্ট্রোলিং, ইজ টেকিং দ্য ডিসিশন হোয়েদার দ্য প্রেজেন্ট ইনপুট নিডস টু বি কমপ্লিমেন্টেড অর কপিড। Okay, that means the control over was over the last input bit. Now here, while going for the gray to binary conversion, you switch the control from the last input to the last output. Last output is also definitely known. When
yes,
you are
sir.
In a present time instant, the last input output both are known to you.
Yeah, yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Mm-hmm. So here you, while going for gray to binary conversion, you just switch the control from the last input to last output. Let us see. Copy the MSB.
So in case of gray to binary, the output will be binary, right?
Yeah.
So how would we know the last output? We have to find the last output.
MSB, MSB, MSB. First case MSB.
Copy the MSB. This is for 9. This is the gray code. 1101. Isn't it? For 9, this is the gray code. 1101. So what is the first step for gray to binary conversion?
Copy MSB 1.
Copy the present input. Copy the MSB. So this one gets copied. Now, what is the rather? What is your input? Input is this. Output is this pattern. Now what is the
last
present output input?
One.
Now what is the present input?
Present input is one.
One.
What is the last output?
One.
One.
One. If the last output is one, what should we do with the present input?
Complemented.
So it has complemented and available as zero. Now what is the present input?
Zero.
Zero.
What is the last output?
Zero.
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 Last output
yes,
is
sir. Zero, 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 zero. Yes, sir.
So what you have to do with the
present input?
Copy. Also copy it as a zero. Now what is the present input?
One.
What is the last output?
Zero.
So what is two is the present input?
Copy.
Copy. So this is the binary for 9 1001. See, this is the result. Correct. Okay. Oh, abar shei problem holo. একবার শুরু হলে না তোমরা ততক্ষণ আর একটা কম্বিনেশন নিয়ে করতে থাকো, সে 12 এরটা করে দাও, 12 এর করেসপন্ডিং গ্রে প্যাটার্ন থেকে বাইরের এই রুলটা ফলো করে কনভার্ট করে নাও। আমি ততক্ষণে দেখছি, ফেরার চেষ্টা করছি। আমার ল্যাপটপ রিস্টার্ট দিতে হয়েছে, 2 মিনিট সময় লেগে যাবে। হ্যাঁ, তোমরা তখন করো। টুয়েলভটা আসলো? ইন দ্যাট কেস ওই একটা বড় বাইনারি প্যাটার্নে গ্রে কোড জেনারেট করেছিলাম, ওইটা গ্রে কোড থেকে তোমার বাইনারিতে নিয়ে গিয়ে দেখো উপরেটা পাচ্ছ কিনা। Have you got the binary pattern?
Yes, sir.
Fine. Now I'm dictating one problem. By the time my laptop restarts, you do it yourself. You write down one binary pattern. 1011 0 triple 1. One zero one one zero triple one, 1 8-bit pattern, isn't it? It's 1 8-bit pattern, though.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Fine.
এটা কে গ্রেতে করতে হবে স্যার?
না 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 না. আমি প্রবলেম টাইম বলবো. 1 8-bit binary pattern is given to you. There's that pattern. Now this pattern represents, you just write, this pattern represents a decimal number. This pattern represents a decimal number in unsigned binary. Decimal number A, there are three parts of the question. The part A is unsigned binary number. B, excess-free BCD number. And C, a gray number, a gray pattern. The given pattern, that 8-bit pattern, represents a decimal number in A, unsigned binary, B, excess-free BCD, and C, gray pattern. Your task is to find out the corresponding decimal number. Your task is to find out the corresponding decimal number. Probably the question is not clear. If it is not clear, raise that doubt, I'll explain.
Sir, what is unsigned?
Unsigned, forget about the whatever binary number you have studied, that's the unsigned number. There is no concept of any sign.
Okay, sir.
There is no concept of positive number or negative number. Just whatever binary numbers or the decimal numbers you have studied so far, they are all the unsigned ones.
Sir, can you repeat the question one more time?
Yeah. I forgot the binary pattern I have given. Assuming that binary pattern you know, one decimal number is represented by the pattern which was supplied to you in A, unsigned binary, B, excess-free BCD, C, gray. You have to find out gray pattern. You have to find out the corresponding decimal number in all three cases. What is the pattern I have given you? 1 0.
1 1.
0 triple 1.
Then? 0 triple 1 problem.
Yes, sir.
Isn't it? So this binary pattern represents a decimal number in you have to find out the corresponding decimal number in all three cases. When the pattern is representing the decimal number in unsigned binary system, what is the decimal number?
Sir, 183.
183. How have you found it?
Sir, 1 in position will have 2 power 0.
1 plus 2 plus 4.
Huh. Yes, sir.
1 plus 2 plus 4, then 8 is not there, 16, 32, 128. Using 8 bit, what is the maximum, what is the largest decimal number that can be represented using 8 bit? Using 4 bit, how, what is the largest decimal number that you can represent?
Fifteen.
Using 5 bits?
31.
So using n bits, what is the largest number?
2 power n minus 1.
Okay. So using 8 bits, what is the largest number?
255.
So what I'll do is, had it been all one, the pattern would have been, the decimal number would have been 255. I'll simply subtract from here the weights of the zeros. It will be less time consuming if the number of zeros is much smaller as compared to the number of ones. ওকে সো অনেক জায়গায় কিন্তু টাইমটা খুব প্রিমিয়াম হয়ে যায়, যে কোনো কম্পিটিটিভ এক্সামিনেশনে তোমার কিন্তু টাইমটা খুব প্রিমিয়াম। সো ইউ শুড লার্ন হোয়াট ইজ দ্য ইজিয়েস্ট অফ দ্য লেস টাইম কনজিউমিং প্রসেস। কিন্তু আমার জিরো অ্যান্ড ওয়ান যদি অলমোস্ট ইকুয়াল নাম্বার থাকতো, সেক্ষেত্রে হোয়াট ইউ হ্যাভ ডান দ্যাটস অলসো ফাইন। এনিওয়ে দিস ইজ 183। ইফ ইট ইজ ইন এক্সেসিভ ইসিডি, what is the decimal number? Bolo, sunte pelam na.
180.
186. 180. 180, why?
Sir, 84.
Yeah, it's 84. Yes, sir. If it is in excessive VCD, as it is, the excessive VCD is also a type of a VCD, so that means we know that every 4 bit will represent one digit. Now, what is the BCD rule that we have used here? An excessive BCD rule. So we have to find out the decimal equivalent of these 4 bits, that is 7. So we have to, now to find out the actual digit, we have to subtract 3 from there. So 7 minus 3, that is 4. Then it is 1011 is nothing but 11. 11 minus 3, that is how much? 8. So this is 84.
Sir, can you explain it once more, sir?
Yeah. Say I the have 1000 and 1100. So excessive BCD. So this is one digit. This is another digit. How have you come to the excessive BCD? You have added with 3 with this DI. And obtained its 4-bit binary. Now we are going to find out, given this code, we are going to find out this DI. So we know that this is nothing but the 4-bit binary of DI plus 3. So what is that DI plus 3? This 1100 is, what is the decimal equivalent value?
7.
No, 1100, what is the decimal equivalent value?
12.
Kato?
12.
So that is 12. So DI plus 3 is your 12. So what will be your DI?
9.
So that means whatever decimal number you are getting from here, you have to subtract 3 from there. How much is DI plus 3 here?
8.
Okay. So what is your DI?
5.
So that is 5. What was that? 9, na? Earlier one?
Yes, sir. 9.
So hope
sir,
now it is here.
Sir, puro 8 bit take DI nao jaya na?
Yeah, bhai. Chahi bhai ki tumi korecho?
So, ওইভাবে করে 180 বললাম
না সেভাবে করবে কেন ওটা ইজ দ্যাট দা রুল সাউ দ্যাট ডিজিট বাই ডিজিট আমরা করতে হবে তাই না
হ্যাঁ
স্যার নাও ইট ইজ গিভেন ইন গ্রেপ আই এ ম্যাডাম একবার শুরু হয়ে গেছে আচ্ছা
236
গ্রেপটা আমি নেক্সট ক্লাসে বলবো হ্যাঁ কিছু কিছু বলছিলে তুমি
স্যার ওই 236 আনসার
এটা আমি না করলে বুঝতে পারবো না
यस
ঠিক আছে আমি চট করে করে দিচ্ছি
স্যার আমার একটা ডাউট ছিল স্যার বলছি আনসাইন্ড বাইনারি ডে তাহলে ওরকম চারটা চারটা ধরে করলাম না
এটা বাইনারি কনভার্টেড ভ্যালু হবে ইজ ইট কামিং আন্ডার দ্য ডি এম বাই বাইনারি কোডস ও নো
নো স্যার
সো দ্যাটস ওয়াই হ্যাঁ আর কে কিছু বলছিলে আচ্ছা এটা আমি জাস্ট করে দিচ্ছি এক্সপ্লেন আমি করছি না সো গ্রে দেন ইট ইজ ওয়ান ওয়ান জিরো ওয়ান ওয়ান দেন ইট ইজ জিরো ইট ইজ ওয়ান জিরো ওকে নাও ফাইন্ড আউট ইটস ডেসিমাল ইকুইভ্যালেন্ট দিস দ্য বাইনারি প্যাটার্ন ফাইন্ড আউট ইটস ডেসিমাল ইকুইভ্যালেন্ট দিস ওয়ান্স अगेन 255 ক্লাস করতে শুরু হয়ে গেছে আমি ছেড়ে দিই নেক্সট আচ্ছা তো আমরা তো একটা কাজ করতেই পারি বা একটু এগোনোর জন্য মঙ্গলবার অ্যাটলিস্ট ওয়ান আওয়ারের জন্য তো আমরা ক্লাস নিতেই পারি তা তোমার ল্যাবটা একটু আগে শুরু করতে পারতাম অর্ণব
यस
স্যার স্যার টিউজডে
ঠিক আছে তাহলে টিউজডে করো না বলো
টিউজডে ল্যাব ক্লাসের টাইমে আপনি ক্লাস নিতেই পারেন
ওই বলে হ্যাঁ টিউজডে ল্যাব ক্লাসের টাইমে আমি একটা অ্যাটলিস্ট ওয়ান আওয়ার আমি একটা নিয়ে নেব কালকে ক্লাস হচ্ছে না কালকে আমি থাকছি না আমি ডিপার্টমেন্টে যাচ্ছি
থ্যাংক ইউ
স্যার
থ্যাংক ইউ স্যার